Right, guys, I'm here with a dead posy at Download Festival. You guys, it's your first time here at the festival, the hallowed ground of Donington Park. What was it like?
A lot of history.
Well, we got here about 4 a.m. because we're sleeping
4 a.m.
Yeah, because we're sleeping in a Sprinter van with six little tiny little bunks that we're sleeping in. They're smaller than coffins, so it's insane. So if you're claustrophobic, it's probably not for you. But they were all sleeping, but our drummer Richie and I, we did a little round about of the whole festival grounds with nobody here. So it was pretty cool. We went on the stage we played at and just kind of checked it out. So it was cool to walk in and see everything.
Must have been like a ghost town.
It was cool. It was like, it honestly reminded me of a circus from like the 1900s.
That's pretty good imagery.
It's amazing being here at all, because we were originally slated to play 2020. It got bumped for COVID reasons, of course. So it's almost been like 3 years in the waiting. Like, yes, it actually happened. We played the show, and it was all that it was cracked up to be and more. You know, it was a great, probably our favorite festival we've done.
And by far.
Yeah.
All the crowd and the fans were incredible, great energy. We were worried because it's early.
Yeah.
I don't like getting out of bed before 11 a.m. So.
It says the person that was up at 4 a.m. this morning.
Well, we're on crazy time now.
Yeah, we're from L.A., so.
We ate a loaf of sourdough bread for dinner last night. We're pirates right now.
That she procured free from a shop.
So we're living on another planet at this moment.
The jet lag setting in and all of that kind of stuff.
It's been set in. We've been here. We played two shows with Theory of a Dead Man. We did two of those, one in London and Glasgow, and now we're here. So, yeah, jet lag's nice and internalized. It's in every cell of the body now.
That's three kind of major locations in the UK to play: London, Glasgow, and then Donington. You're hitting the big places
straight
away.
Covered all the spots, yeah.
It's fun. We were at Glasgow last night. It was incredible. It was a nice punk rock show, would you say?
Very much so.
Yeah.
It was some technical craziness, but it rocked.
Everyone brought the energy in Glasgow, so cheers to Glasgow.
And London, it's been 3 for 3 with a nice capper at Download, so it's been fantastic.
Well, they're all known for their good crowds, the places that you played, so that's fantastic. Where did you play in Glasgow?
We played...
The Garage.
The Garage was yesterday.
Yesterday, yep.
Yes. London on Thursday. Garage in England.
But London, where did we play in London?
The O2 Academy.
O2 Academy, that's right.
Oh, okay, in Kentish Town. Did you get to see Camden for a little bit?
We did
the day before. Cause
we walked around and all that fun stuff. Did the train. We walked about 20,000 steps, right?
Yeah.
We were all over the place.
We were trying to stay up so that when it hit nighttime, we'd fall asleep, do the jet lag
thing. Yeah.
We were just walking and taking the tube. And
we slept in the park for a little bit. Which park was it? It would have been...
Regent's Park.
Regent's Park. I was going to say,
you have to pick your parts carefully in London if you're going
to
do that.
We did. We went to Regent's Park and it was pleasant.
So it is our third time to England, so it's not the first time, but I'll say every trip has gotten better and better, and man, what a way to finish it. We wish we were still staying out here and playing more, you know?
So you're heading straight back after this, are you?
We are.
We are. Flights are not fun, but we will be on a flight tomorrow. But we should be back soon.
Fantastic. Well, as I said to you before the interview, besides loving the music that I've been sent and playing it on the show, I don't really know much of you about a band, so I'm guessing some of the listeners
will get you to know it.
Let's get us up to speed.
Nice to meet you.
What should we say to them?
Man, that's hard to do.
Well, I know. The one thing I do know that I heard is that you've been very successful in the States with some of your songs being picked up for TV shows.
Yes.
And the big TV shows as well. We're talking Marvel, Lucifer, some of these big hitters. That must be amazing.
Yeah, you know, our first EP, it had, at the time, the right sound, I think, for a lot of those TV shows. Yeah. And that helped us get a fan base relatively early. Earlier than baby bands usually get.
Yeah.
And that's how we were able to start touring and opening for bigger bands early on. And I just feel like we're in another era now where, ironically, we're not getting any of those placements for TV shows because I think our music's maybe more punk rock, rock and roll a little bit more now. So hopefully we're hoping someone like David Lynch or something wants to use one of our new songs.
That would be cool, wouldn't it?
So we shall see.
Yeah, I mean, it was great to have that because it allowed us to have a launching point and kind of help fund some things early on, you know, because bands, you know, things keep getting more expensive, but bands are still keep got to do
the bottom of the totem pole.
Yeah, it's an amazing vehicle, though, isn't it? Because, you know, it's a way for your music to get out to people that it otherwise would not do in any way.
And in this day and age, you really need that because there's so much out there now. There's so many great bands, you know, great things you can spend your time doing. So any band needs a boost here and there. That was our boost initially, allowed us to come to things like this. So,
Now we're thankful. It's a good start, I feel, for us. But now we're in the phase of we just want to be on the road and touring, and that's most important to us after this album.
Which is really difficult at the moment because dates are booked up, lineups are rolled forward.
Crew, everybody's touring.
People to work with you is all booked up. We had we had like three people cancel on us last minute before this run to just even be our kind of general tour manager and helper out here. Luckily, we found awesome guy at the last minute, Cole, but we were almost, you know, very in a rough spot. So.
We almost had to drive ourselves, and we've never driven over here. I was down for the adventure, though. I like driving at night, so I was all for it.
Yeah, you were ready.
But Cole came to save the day.
He did.
I can just imagine, like, a scene from Planes, Trains, and Automobiles in that situation.
We referred to that on the first day when we were on trains and planes. And then we were in London.
And an automobile.
Yeah, we were everywhere.
Yeah, we really were.
Really were.
But what's the strategy for you guys then? You say you want to be out on the road, but like I said, the dates are booked up. Have you got stuff planned in? Have you gone in a certain direction to try and get those booked up?
Yeah, so, you know, the business side of things, it's just a matter of things clicking into place, and we shall see. To be determined. We have a tour lined up in September, October. We just haven't announced it yet with the band that we're going to be supporting.
Really excited about it. Yeah, it'll be a nice, long, like, six-week tour.
Oh, wow.
Through Canada and the States.
Decent-sized rooms. It'll be good. Yeah.
So that'll be fun. And then we're hoping that the stars align and we get booked on one or two of the tours that we're being submitted for over here. So fingers crossed. In October...
October, November, maybe. We've got good, solid agents doing their thing, so, you know.
We're ready. Put us in, coach. Yeah. Let's fucking go.
How far ahead are you trying to have to think about these kind of things at the moment? Because
months and months.
Long time.
Yeah, months and months they plan stuff. But then sometimes it's last minute because something happens. So it's really all over the place. It's a little bipolar. So you just kind of have to go with the chaos at this point.
It's going
to
work out well for us because we have one festival in the U.S. in July, but basically the next 2 to 2.5 months will be about really trying to hunker down and finish as much as we can of the album, rest of the album track, so then we can do the touring and just have that kind of done and in the can. Yeah. So it's hard to do both at the same time.
Oh, absolutely.
It's two different mindsets, really. You know, it's two totally different ways of doing it. So. Yeah.
Do you get to road test the new songs then? Do you play them live?
We did two today, unreleased songs.
It's been fun.
I'm sorry, we only did one because we had to cut a song.
Yeah.
All the other shows far.
And our set's all new from when we played 2 years ago, so it's fun for us. Because we just had a short run in the States a week and a half ago, so it was nice to start this new era with a whole new set, and then we came over here playing the whole new set over here, so we're liking where we are right now.
Yeah,
it's been fun.
Fantastic. Well, guys, thank you so much for taking the time to speak to me today,
and
good luck with the rest of the album making and the tours that you got coming up.
Amazing.
So
cheers.
Much.
Cheers.